comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say it's all right.
My name is James Hayden, and this is Travis Frazer, and we're Group 11.
And for our third and final project, we made a survey method that you can scan an area for what metal or magnets might be in there, and then make a 3D plot of the magnetic field in that scan area.
Cool.
So this is what we're leading up to in our last project. We've actually taken the array and mounted it on that innermost carriage. So it's going to start sweeping around. And if I actually have the program running from last time, so if I move this magnet, it's going to follow the magnet around. But now, instead of moving the magnet, it's moving the carriage to be centered over that magnet. And so then, that's last time's program. This time, we have that scanning pattern I talked about. So we want to scan this little face right here. And that's going to be the next thing we do, is see what kind of 3D image we can get of this face's magnetic field. It's these are magnets and these are metal bars. We did a preliminary test of the metal bar, and it actually was a very good plot. You can see very definitely that was the orientation of the bar side to side. So we'll see if we can get a clear plot of this face. So now we're in the middle of the scan. You can see our waveform charts are picking up some spikes, and it's going side to side over that. We'll see in about 3 minutes what kind of pattern it made. I'll show you while it's going the block diagram for this. Basically, we have everything running off of a little touch sensor right here, so that when it reaches the edge of its scan, it's going to touch the button, which is going to move it forward to start the next row and reverse the direction of the motors. And then it's also going to initiate the data taking from the lab jack. Oh, and that's for the waveforms on the front. So it's going to take 50 samples across, one every 100 milliseconds. It moves forward 100 milliseconds, and it moves forward for 100 rows. So it's going to do a kind of zigzag like that. And so it's going to give a 50 by 50 matrix that we're going to then feed into MATLAB to make our 3D plot. So this is the plot that MATLAB produced. It is a 3D plot. But the clearest where you can tell what's going on is with it up like this. This bit up here is just noise. Ignore that. This is the face here. You can see the eyebrows, the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. And you can see that this is kind of split like that. That's because the timing was off in the going side to side. This is actually, they'd be meshed together like that more. So if you imagine these coming together, there would be the nose, the eye, and that'd be something that if we were to, you know, continue to work on this with, you know, further projects, we'd actually get the timing precise. But as it is, you can definitely tell that face shape that we had might not be incredibly clear, but after you think about it, you can see that we picked up the magnetic field of a face.
In Project 3, we had attempted a new circuit. The purpose of this was to transfer information wirelessly from the array to the computer. It was a signal modification circuit. We had two plans. Originally, the plan was to build an oscillator and then bring in a DC current and add it to a summer and then process it through a linear multiplier. You would essentially get a wave that looked like this. Unfortunately, we couldn't afford a linear multiplier. So by circumstance, I ran across a modified summer slash op amp. What we did was the same thing from plan one we did with plan two. The only thing that differed, I put an additional op amp summer and grounded it the wrong way. By chance, it happened to give me a wave that looked like this. Basically, these two remain the same, while the middle can move up and down depending on whether or not you increase or decrease the DC voltage. After we attained a wave like this, I had to modify the signal coming from the array. In order to do so, we had to have a difference op amp, which subtracted two signals, and then an amplifier. The signal came out okay. It basically looked something like this. Unfortunately, when we put it with this circuit, the final wave came out something like this. And there were several occasions where clipping occurred.
In the end, the circuit didn't work. It was a great proof of concept. In the future, we would need to fix the clipping.
The guy from,
So this is the code that controls our writing program. We have the keyboard controlling this case structure so that if you push any of these letters, it'll go to a predetermined flat sequence that will go through the steps to write that letter.
So there were a few things we learned. I learned that potentiometers are key. The placement of them are very important. Depending on what you need to adjust is where you want to put the potentiometer. I also learned that when you use multiple op amps, you want to be sure about clipping. Clipping definitely becomes an issue.
Yeah, did you want to talk about that 25?
Yes. Also, that's a good point. It's very important throughout this whole project, all three of them, that 25% design, 25% build, and 50% test. And if you're really good, you often do more than 50% testing.
Yeah, and some of the things I learned with the coding was, I showed you earlier that button. That really cleared things up. I was trying to get everything to be timed, and it just was not working at all. And then I followed suit from some other groups that they had it running off of when a button was pushed, which was a lot better for syncing it to what's physically going on. Also, I was trying to output the data in that 50 by 50 matrix already, and LabVIEW just could not build it properly as it was going. And so finally, at the suggestion of Dr. Bensky, and I think Dr. Matt may have mentioned it too, they said, we'll just put it out in a solid stream of data, and then actually turn it into a matrix in MATLAB, which cleared that right up. So, I guess that's it. Thank you for watching. We enjoyed making this project, and we'll see you later on down the road.
It's been a pleasure. Here comes the